Hello, my name is Chris Neutwoom from PostNL, the major postal company in Holland, and we are going to talk about our order management system, which we build in Mendix. We're actually going to take you into an order management ABC, which includes first the architecture, the business, and the cooperation between three parties, PostNL, Mendix, and the Cape Group. First, I'm going to talk a bit about business, about PostNL and its activities. After that, Terence will tell you something about the architecture of the system. And after that, Arthur from the Cape Group will tell you something about the cooperation between Mendix, PostNL and the Cape Group. Well, PostNL is a postal company which is mostly famous for delivering letters, 50 million pieces a day, and parcels, 1.5 million pieces a day. But further, we are an all-round logistical company which delivers furniture, large goods, freight, medics. We do cool transport, we do secure transport, we do, express services, so an all-round company. But this case is about our parcels division for which we built an order management system. The PostNL Parcels division is benefiting from the e-commerce rise, which started in about 2010. People started to order more on the internet, and then the number of parcels we had to deliver was rising and rising, and it doubled in the past 10 years. At this moment, we have busy times, and we have less busy times. At this moment, at the corona times, it's very, very busy because a lot of people don't go to the city to order something, but they stay at home and order it by e-commerce. So we are in a very busy period. This is the rise of e-commerce. After that, in 2010, we started with a new parcels infrastructure, of which you see an example here. This is our sorting center. We call it the depot. It's a building built around a sorting machine, and the parcels are processed here. In the left corner, you see a chart of a map of Holland with all the locations in it. And we are also working in Belgium, so we're focusing on the Netherlands and Belgium. And this is one of the examples of our sorting center. We have 32 of those sorting centers, and we are still building. Well, in the parcel business, there is a very high need for information. We need to have information about the parcels which we have to distribute, because without this, we can't really do it well. We need information about, of course, where to deliver it, how to deliver it, at what time to deliver it. Do we have to get a signature? Are we allowed to deliver the parcel with the neighbors? And so on and so on. If we don't have the information, we can't do it really efficient. So this order management system which we built in Mendix is very important for us. Well, here you see a picture of the inside of the depot, a lot of roller cages with all kinds of parcels, small parcels, big parcels. It's very busy. It's in the morning, it's completely packed with parcels. I already said 1.5 million orders a day, so each parcel has its own order. We call it an order. And of course, there are changes on the orders. So people change the order because they want to have the parcel delivered somewhere else. So there are changes. And this system is processing these 1.5 million orders daily. It's a microservices-based IT system. And Terence will tell you all about it in the architecture part.
Hi, my name is Terence. I work at the Cape Group. Chris has just told you about something about the business side of things, and I will be telling you about the architecture supporting this business. In the landscape, we have 32 depots, and per depot, we will be deploying two apps. And we do that so that we have the same capacity needed for each of these apps, as these depots are also limited physically in what capacity they can handle. Now we have an input app that's mostly technical in nature. It will be responsible for receiving orders and events in high volumes. And we have a process app that does mostly the business processing. So the business logic is in here. Most of the changes that we need to make will land into the process app, meaning that we'll deploy that far more often than the input app. So even during deployments, we're still open for business, so we can still receive messages. This process app needs to send the route to the field services platform and also send the order updates to the rest of the landscape to inform them about the status of the order. What we also have, we're not only scalable in this way, so if a new depot is opened because the business also needs to scale, we scale in the same way. We also deploy two more apps in that case, an input app and a process app. The other thing with this architecture is that we can roll out this landscape gradually. So we don't have to deploy everything at once. We can start testing releases on one depot, and if we see everything is okay, we can roll it out to the rest of the landscape. So we do that for initial rollout, but we can also do that later on for the next releases. Now, of course, with 70 apps, we also have some new challenges. We have, of course, user management to worry about. So do I have to enter the user accounts in all these apps if they have access to, well, let's say they have access to 60 apps. Do I have to enter the same user account everywhere? I also have to configure data within these apps. And I don't want to do that every time or every single time the same thing for the same app, like 30 times. So how do we solve that? Now, also, we want to really have a controlled way of rolling it out. So I don't want to be clicking buttons as much to roll out 70 apps. I want it to be automated if possible. And next, also, I want to really have control. What is this system doing? How can I see what it is doing? So how can I test it? How can I monitor it? These are all new challenges that come with a landscape like this. Now, in part, we solve this by a new application in Mendix called the Application Manager, which we actually built in cooperation with also some people from Mendix. And within this application, we can configure pipelines to do the deployment steps. So we can completely automate the deployment over the environments for the apps. And we don't just have test, acceptance, and production in this case. We also have a performance environment where we can do performance tests on an environment that's scaled as production. And we have a soak environment where we can deploy a release and test it for a longer period and see if anything goes wrong after a while or not. We have a pre-production environment where we can do a testing of deployments before we actually go to production. And also we can use it if anything happens in production and we need to debug, we can take the data to pre-production and test it there and do some debugging there instead of having to do something like that on production. Now, the other part of application management is the monitoring. So we can define within the apps metrics ourselves, metrics like internal queue size or amount of errors that occurred within a process, and also the duration of the processing of orders, for instance. Now, we can keep track of that and see what the landscape or what these apps in this landscape are doing. And we can also set thresholds that if duration goes above a certain threshold, we get an alert. So we can handle proactively before there's actually a problem with the apps. Another part that we have to solve is user management, so that we don't have repetitive work on entering accounts for people in multiple apps. And within the landscape at PostNL, we have a Mendix app, central user management, that can handle it for all the Mendix app at PostNL, part of which is, of course, also this new order system, order management system. And we receive the identities from the identity provider in the landscape. And for these identities, we can then configure the accounts for the particular apps. Now, this means that we don't have to do this 70 times, for instance, for the order management system, just a single time. And we also, within the system of the order management, we have a portal application. And this portal application receives the configured accounts from the user management application. And the portal application is then responsible for distributing these accounts within the system. So this kind of hides the complexity of this system for user management. And other role for portal is to also have some screens for data configurations. So as you might be able to imagine, we have to configure quite a bit of data also within applications. And this can be quite repetitive. For instance, the 32 process apps all need the same data. I do not want to enter this 32 times, so I am able to do this within the portal app, and the portal app will distribute this. Now, I hope this gives you some insight in the architecture for this order management system and also the things we had to do to solve this rather large landscape of almost 70 apps. Next, Arthur will tell you something about how we organized all of this with three parties, PostNL, Mendix, and Cape Group.
Oh, thank you, Terence. It feels like yesterday, but it's already a long time ago. In 2017, we started with PostNL Mendix cooperating on that order management systems, and we started with a few simple questions, and not simple questions, but questions we had to solve to make this project to a success. Now, Chris and Terence already told you a lot about the outcome of this process, and I will talk you something about how we did that. But we started with this picture with Mendix. We visit Mendix here in Rotterdam, and we said, now we see these problems or these challenges for the future. From this moment on, we cooperated with Mendix and PostNL to solve these issues. Now, low TCO, low total cost of ownership, reusability. But one of the things that was very important was the generic architecture, where we should, we had 4 or 5 ohms to make, order managements to make, and we wanted to reuse them. So what we brought in? The business problems were, of course, those of PostNL. They had already quite good learning organization and a lot of methodology knowledge about Scrum, about SAFe. So that was a real big help that they brought that in the project. Experience with big systems and application management, architecture and knowledge of methodology knowledge is also coming from us. And of course, a lot of help from Mendix with about architecture and product knowledge. Now, in the end, I think we had a very good cooperation, and every team, every company had a good payoff. So PostNL had a very scalable application, as Terence and Chris already told you, and capable of building themselves. So what we are training them is learning to build applications themselves, so they're not depending on other groups. And of course, more and more methodology experience. Now, we learned as Cape Group to bring TCO in and lowering application management. We can do, for a low cost, we can do a lot of application management in the future. Of course, we learned also from experience. And yeah, a little bit proud. We learned more about building big systems. And together, as Terence already told you, we have an extended CI/CD suite. Now, for Mendix, of course, experience with high performance applications, application management module. So you can deploy a lot of applications at the same moment, same time, and an extended CI/CD suite with new APIs, new functionality, also in the Mendix platform. Yeah, and to be honest, we had some we had to learn to trust each other. We had to learn to have working together in a learning environment. But what we did, we organized a joint architecture board with PostNL, Mendix, and Cape Group, and we created joint teams. So there are people of Mendix cooperating in the teams, people of the Cape Group, and of course, a lot of people of PostNL who are joining together, build this this application. And yeah, what's very important is, and what we already learned, is keep your eyes on the future. Now, I will give the word to Chris for the end note and for the common the present situation of the application.
We have users on 32 locations. The users are actually planners who do working packages for 4,000 drivers in Holland and in Belgium. So they assemble with this order management system, the routes for 4,000 drivers. So these drivers will manage to deliver all the parcels in their route within an acceptable amount of time, like 8 hours. At this time, it's very busy, so they work a lot of extra time at the moment, and we have a lot of extra drivers running around. But the system is mainly for planning the routes of those 4,000 drivers. It's a very intensive subservicing processing system, so there are a lot of user interfaces, but mainly the work of the system in Mendix is done under the servers, so a lot of processing of the orders. We have some very advanced screens, feature-rich, which the users use, but in fact, the calculation under the sea level is very intensive. It's very analysis friendly system. It's not a black box where something happens. We have a lot of reporting. We have a lot of screens which are easy to make in Mendix, and this way we can follow exactly what the orders do, how they are processed, what the status is. So it's actually a very glass-like box system instead of a black box system. The system is fit for further growth. In the architecture part, we will tell you more about this. We can expand the system in the coming years, in the coming 10 to 15 years maybe, because we still expect the number of parcels will rise and rise. It's highly customizable because it's not a standard package. It's all built for purpose. So we are very flexible in changing things we want to change. And what's maybe most important is, apart from being a very reliable system and a very stable system, is that we expect to be able to offer new service offerings in a small amount of time. We have a lot of new things. You see on the slide, you see one example, our parcel locker, where you can deliver your parcels or get your parcels, which are distributed. But we want to make it more easy for you to deliver to and receive your parcels wherever you want and whenever you want. And those are the new service offerings we have in the future. And we expect this to be able to build it really easily on this new system. Well, at the moment of this presentation, the implementation of the system, which is ready at the moment, is halfway. You can see it in the left side, the map of Netherlands and Belgium. All the green depots are in production. The yellow depots still have to be done. So we are halfway. We are continuing till the 1st of October, and then the complete project should be finished. There are loads of new initiatives on the backlog. I talked before about new service offerings. Well, so we in the coming time we have loads to do and loads to change on the system. So we keep really busy developing our system further in Mendix. Well, finally, I'd like to thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions or you're interested in our system, please contact us, either the CAPE Group or Mendix or PostNL. Thank you.